In this video, we will learn how to subtract instrumental broadening from XRD data using Origin. When we shine X-rays on the crystal, the X-rays go into the crystal through diffraction, and from the planes of the crystal, some X-rays are reflected to the detector that make a diffraction pattern. However, when the planes of the same crystal shrink, X-rays deviate from its original position, and as a result, the whole XRD pattern shifts. While, when a defect occurs in the same crystal, X-rays reflect at different angles from each plane and cause a broadening in the XRD peak. Broadening caused by the sample may consist of many involved defects of the crystal, which mainly includes crystallite size, microstrain, solid solution and homogeneity, and temperature factors. We have already discussed the broadening due to the crystallite size in this video, while the microstrain in this video. However, broadening of the XRD peak is not only due to the sample, but can also be due to the instrument. To get the actual broadening due to the sample, we will have to subtract the broadening caused by the instrument, which can be done with the help of measurement of some standards. Here we can see the magnitudes of contribution to the peak broadening from the instrument as well as from the sample. Ideally, it is to be like a delta function with negligible width, and the broadening caused by the instrumental factors will be this much. When crystallite size will aid with this, the width increases further, and so on if microstrain contribution is added with these two. In the instrumental broadening, the two major components are the X-ray source and the X-ray machine optics. In the X-ray source, broadening is caused by these, in which we have already discussed the superposition of K-alpha-1 and K-alpha-2 peaks in the video, which is shown in the info card above. While in the X-ray machine optics, out of the many involved factors, some are as follows. X-ray focus, dispersion, absorption, divergence, misalignments, detector slits, and many more parameters. However, all these factors contribute to the instrumental peak broadening. In the instrument peak profile, we will have to take care in the choice of standards as well as during the measurements. Some of the standards are these, in which we will consider the lanthanum hexaboride. Other materials can also be considered as standards, provided that the variation in FWHM is almost linear with respect to an increase in 2 theta values. In the measurement, we will have to collect data from a standard using the same configuration as adopted for the sample. And there should be almost no overlapping peaks of the standard with the sample. In the instrument peak profile, shape of the peak will be taken into consideration for calculating the instrumental broadening. When the standard peak is in Gaussian shape, we will have to use this expression, and when it is in Lorentzian shape, this expression will be utilized. Let's go to the origin to start with the XRD data of lanthanum hexaboride. It is preferred to find FWHM of all these peaks and take their average value. However, as the difference that comes out is very less, so we can focus on one intense peak somewhere in the middle and will calculate its FWHM. Let me zoom this peak and it is here. We have already discussed in the previous video that the first peak corresponds to K-alpha-1 and the second peak to the K-alpha-2. I will focus on the K-alpha-1. To find its FWHM, go to Analysis, Peaks and Baseline, multiple peak fetch and open dialog. Go on with the Gaussian function. Double click to pick the peaks. Open nonlinear fetch. Click few iterations to see that fitting is good, then fit until converge. First, check that both the peaks have been fitted well. Select the plots and ungroup. Change the size to see the overlapping peaks. Now, go to the data and copy the FWHM value of the first peak from the nonlinear fit peak 1 under the summary tab. Let's open the Excel template for calculations. This is the FWHM is calculated from the sample. Here we will have to paste the FWHM value of the standard. As our peak was Gaussian in shape, so we will consider this expression. And here is the instrumental contribution subtracted value of the FWHM. We can utilize this value for the calculation of many parameters from the XRD data. Thanks for watching the video.